The students in today's class will be studying fundamental constituents of organizational behavior. In this subject, organizational behavior, there are a basic topics that we have to study. There is means I can say that elements of the subject, main elements, core things of the subject. Those things that constituents they form the whole subject matter. Let's see what they are. So these are the fundamental constituents of organizational behavior. In the when we say organizational behavior, that means that is affected with these three things. Organization behavior is formed by first thing, individual. Every individual is a cause for the organizational behavior. Second, group. Every group that is existing in the organization, various departments are there, various categories of the workers are there. They are considered as a one group of people. Managers group, then lower level degraded workers group. So production people, there are various categories of the group, categories. So they make a group. Then there is a job and technology. So what kind of a job you are having, what kind of the implements, tools that you are using in the production, that is also a matters. Then organizational design, how your process, methods of the working you have framed, that is also a subject matter of organization behavior. Then we have a environment. Overall, the environment of the organization affects a lot. So these constituents we will be studying in today's class. Let's see each one. So first, individual. So in the organization, people are working as a group, we know. But each person, each individual differs. And he has his own way of going about, his style of functioning and his behavior. An individual plays a significant role in the establishment of an organization. Thus, it is the essential constituent of organizational behavior. The behavior of individuals is studied in organizational behavior by performing various studies for each category of individuals. What it says is, in the organizational behavior, each individual behavior's study is made. That's very important, because how individual behaves, what is the matter of individual? Now take example, for which job a man should be taken, for which job a woman should be taken. If a man is working, how he should be treated, how if a woman is there, how it should be treated. That background itself should be understood. Then depends on the religion backgrounds, then depends on the educational background. See, the demographic aspects of each and every individual has something to do with the individual. So even the workers from a different place, different parts of the country differ. They are not the same. So you have to treat differently. The cultural backgrounds also have a influence on the work. Therefore, when you are studying organizational behavior, we have to study individual. Individual's behavior has to be made a thorough study, and that's the subject matter of organizational behavior. It makes a study of the individual. Second, group. See, the organization means it is a group of people. Absolutely, if it is a one individual, there is no organizational behavior. It is the owner and he himself is working there. But when we are making a study of organizational behavior, there is a group of people. And in the big organizations and all, there is no one group. There are many groups of the people. Now managerial category is there, then other categories are there. Now you take example of the hospitals. See, in the hospitals there are various departments. Departments, medicine department, then departments like doctors and administrative staff, nurse, then there are sweepers and cleaners. all these categories becomes each group, and within that group, each group also there are different departments in the in the hospital. So each department's people become one group. So group has to be understood very well. Group behavior in an organization, people work as a unit, which is often termed as a group. See, whole organization is one group considered. Hence, groups of human beings have a special dominance in organizational behavior. Organizational behavior studies the behavior of a person as an individual and as a member of a group. See, how a member, when they see, sometimes individually he may be very well, very excellent, but when relating to others, he may not cooperate, he doesn't relate. Those aspects also has to be considered. In some matters, if a person who doesn't relate with anybody, doesn't communicate properly, then such person cannot be appointed as a head of the particular department or anything, because the work will lag. Therefore, the group behaviors of an individual also has to be considered and seen properly. Therefore, see, these are the fundamental constituents of the organizational behavior. What are studying? We are studying the individual, we are studying the group behavior. Now, third, what we are going to study? Third, job and technology. Job may be defined as the total work which has been assigned to an individual at a workplace. So, thus there arises a need to be attentive regarding job. Attention regarding job. Why do we require to give attention to the job? See, job also has an importance for the individual and group behavior. If your job is designed properly and it's a competitive, challenging, then people also have an interesting. If your job is not interesting, then people may not be enthusiastic in doing the job. Or sometimes the job may be such a hazardous that people are not having interest in it. Therefore, you must be seeing what kind of a job is. And is your job is paid properly? So sometimes if your job is highly challenging, then you have to pay more for the people who are involved. Now, if your job is more hazardous, then what is your payment? Who are the workers? That all things has to be kept in mind. Who is doing what job? Therefore, is job fitting to a particular category of the group who are doing, and is that payment is equal, and is there any motivating factors to continue in that job? That is a matter of studies of the organization behavior. Therefore, job need to be studied and in relation with the group and the individual. Then the technology, thus the behavior of an individual is also affected by the techniques and equipment which have been provided for the completion of the job. They will show a positive behavior if the technique and equipment are as per their choice. Hence, it can be said that both job and technology are the vital components of organizational behavior. What it says is, to do a particular job, what are the equipments you are providing? What are the machinery you are giving? What are the technology that you are using? What are the methods that you have asked your workers to do? So, if they are satisfactory, if they are good, if you are providing a good facilitated equipments there, then the individual behavior is good. Therefore, the technology, the equipments what you are giving, the machinery what you are giving, providing, has an influence on the individual as well as the group behavior. And you are, therefore, the job, and to do that job, what are the technology, equipments, methods that you are using is also a subject matter of the organization behavior, because that has an impact on each and every individual who is working in the organization. Next. So, organizational design. What is this organizational design? So, every organization is designed, means organized. Another word we say, the functions of management we say, planning, then second comes organizing. See, everything need to be organized, systematized. The relationships of people at workplace are very much subjective to the organization design. The creation of organization design is directly linked with the nature of a job. A suitable organization design should be performed keeping in mind a particular situation. It becomes easier to regulate the behavior of employees if the organizational design proves to be active. So, if the organization design is not proper and in order, then people, workers, employees may not be happy with that. If the organizational design is such a systematic and feels very comfortable, everything is in proper channels and proper communication line is drawn, then everybody will be happy. Now basically the organization structure, organizational design, what it matters is organization structure. Who is the authority, who is under whose control, and who is having what responsibility and authority, that has to be properly drawn up. Otherwise there will be a confusion. Therefore organizational design is also a matter of study. What kind of a job is there and what kind of the organization design you have made it, that has an influence on the behavior of a individual and a group. Therefore when you are studying organizational behavior, you have to take into consideration even the organizational design. Let's move with the final point, and that is the environment. So environment is one of the major aspect of studying the organizational behavior, because what kind of environment we are working. So environment means everything comes there, internal as well as external. So everything affects there. See, every organization is a part of society, and different parts of the society such as family, government, social groupings and communities together form environment. These factors of environment have an influence on the behavior of individuals, and this influence is studied with the help of organizational behavior. What it says is the environment of every individual, the environment of a location where you are working, the environment of people who are surrounded by, the environment of the government, the environment of the culture, the environment of the groups, the environment of the communities, whatever surrounding is there has an influence on the people who are working. Because we are all coming from the families, we are coming from the communities, we are all coming from a particular place. Therefore each individual has some influence of all those, his family, his place, his culture, his community, and his language, his religion, all this has influence, and these influences is carrying and coming for the work. Therefore at workplace these all have a impact. Therefore the environment is also one of the constituents in studying the organizational behavior. Therefore when we are making a study of organizational behavior, we can't study without making without considering these aspects. These are the first one is individual, second one is group, and third one is a job and technology, and the fourth one we have is organizational design, and fifth one we have the environment. These all aspects we have to study it detailedly. Therefore today I will close here. So you please go through the fundamental constituents of organizational behavior. Thank you.